First topic in integral calculus, that is evolute and radius of curvature, evolute and involute of a curve, which comes from the idea of curvature and radius of curvature. What is curvature and what is radius of curvature, I have already discussed in the last class. So today we will again, if you have any confusion on this discussion, can ask me again I will recap something, then again I will define the evolute of a curve. Anyone is having any question on this part, on radius of curvature, how these are defined, and what are the expression, how the expression of curvature and radius of curvature is introduced? Anyone is having any question on that? Well, then let us start it. So these are all discussed. Curvature of the curve at point P is dIds, where psi is the angle made by the tangent with x-axis. Okay, let everyone enter, then I can start only. Adrita Pathak, can you hear me? Adrita Pathak, can you hear me? Adrita Pathak, good morning, Anmol. Sneha Sarkar, can you hear me? Sneha Sarkar. Mighal Pandey. Can everyone hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Someone is not answering. What is Sneha Sarkar? Sneha Sarkar is not answering. Okay. Whatever it is, I don't understand what is happening for some. Let us start it. So this part was all done, then Cartesian equation for the curvature and radius of curvature. So this was also done, I think, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then next is the definition of the center of curvature. So suppose this x is very close to P, then the circle which will touch both the tangent at P and Q, and the center can be found by producing this radius drawn perpendicular to P and Q. So obviously two radii will cut at a point C, and that C will be taken as the center of the center of the curvature. Okay, center of the circle of the curvature. So if when the curve is changing its direction, so this center will change continuously. Okay, so everywhere there will be some different circle with different radius. Okay, depending on the nature of changing. Okay, since the curvature, the rate of at which the curve will curve, changes direction is not same. So the expression for the curvature is not same. So the radius of the expression will also different. That means if this radius, the CP and CQ, whatever it is changing continuously with the curve, then we will have a locus of the center of this circle. This circle is called the circle of curvature at P. Now, if I continuously traverse this curve along P to Q to other points, then we will have some continuously changing centers. Okay, so adding all these centers, that will give you one locus of the center. That is called the evolute of the curve fx. Okay, evolute of the curve fx. So first of all, how to find the centers? So suppose this center is having the coordinate x bar, y bar. This is the coordinate of center, and obviously this P is the point xy, say P is the point xy. So OB will be obviously x. OB is x, and PB is y. Okay, PB is y. Then OB we can write OA plus AB. OA plus AB. Now what is OA? OA is nothing but x bar. That is the x coordinate of the center, x bar. Okay. Then what is OB is equal to OA plus AB. So OA is x bar, and what is AB? What is AB? AB is nothing but SP, because we draw a perpendicular from P to this AC. AC is also perpendicular to x-axis, so SP will be perpendicular to AB. Okay, so hello.
Yes, sir.
X bar plus AB, that is x bar plus SP. And what is SP? SP is basically R sine phi. Okay, because this is your phi, this is your phi. So what is this? This is the angle between x axis and the tangent. Now this is the parallel to tangent, perpendicular to tangent PC, and that is the perpendicular to x axis AC. Okay, so they will have the same angle. I have already explained this in the previous class. If two straight line is having an angle psi between them, then the perpendicular on them will have the same angle between them, isn't it? Isn't that been discussed in the last class?
Yes.
Okay.
So if this tangent and this x-axis is having some angle psi, that is the angle made by tangent on x-axis, then x-axis having the perpendicular AC, and this tangent has perpendicular PC. So this angle, what is that? PCA. PCA. This angle will be again phi. So if this is phi, this is SP, and this is CP. So what is that? Perpendicular by hypotenuse. So SP by PC, that is R sine phi. That means SP is equal to R sine phi. Is that okay to everyone?
Sir, explain this one.
See, this is phi. You consider this angle, CSP. This triangle you consider, CSP. Now, in this triangle, what is the base? Tell me, what is the base? CS. What is the hypotenuse? CP. And SP is the height. So what is the sine psi? CP. SP by CP. And what is CP?
Hypotenuse,
but what is in the context of
radius,
the
radius?
That is the radius.
Radius
of curvature. So this CP is R. That means this SP by R is equal to sin psi. So SP is equal to R sin psi.
Okay.
I think it is clear to all.
Yes, sir.
Just please respond. Then I cannot see your face, so I cannot understand whether I should proceed or not. So please respond. So PC is the radius of the curvature. Similarly, AC is equal to, what is AC? This AC. AC is the Y bar. AC is nothing but the Y coordinate of the center of curvature, Y bar. So that can be written, AC is equal to, we can say it is equal to RB also, or this way, AS plus SC, AS plus SC. Now what is AS? That is obviously equal to BP, because SP is parallel to x-axis. So these are all perpendicular to x-axis. So SA will be same as BP. And what is BP? BP is nothing but Y, the Y coordinate of the point P. Okay. So AC will be equal to AS plus SC, that is BP plus SC. BP plus SC. And what is BP? That is Y. So Y plus SC. And what is SC? Now tell me, what is SC in terms of psi? What I can write? SC. Similarly to how we have found SP, R sin psi. So what should be the value of SC? If I consider the same triangle, CSP.
R cos psi.
Very good. So this should be R cos psi, because this is the base by hypotenuse is cos psi. So this SC will be R cos psi. So this expression will be Y plus R cos psi. So we are having these things. Okay, there I have shown this thing. So we are having X is equal to X bar R sin psi, and Y bar equal to Y plus SC. That is, Y is equal to Y bar minus R cos psi. Y bar is equal to Y bar minus R cos psi. So let me write it down. These are the equations. Okay, it is already given, I think, in the this one. So X bar is X minus this one. Now let me tell you, what is cos psi and sin psi? What is cos psi and sin psi? See, here I have taken tan psi. What is tan psi? That is the slope of this tangent. Everybody knows this tan psi. Tan psi is equal to dy dx. So tan psi is equal to dy dx. Now sin psi, this is nothing but tan psi into cos psi. That is tan psi by sec psi. And sec psi is equal to root over of sec square, that is tan square plus 1. That means I want to express sin psi in terms of tan psi. This I can do this way. Everybody is clear? Sin psi in terms of tan psi.
So someone waiting.
Someone is waiting. Okay. So up to this is clear to all. I am writing sin psi in terms of tan psi. Tan psi is y1. So what we can write? Y1 by 1 plus y1 square. Y1 by root over of 1 plus y1 square. This is your sin psi. And what is cos psi? That will be again cos psi into sin psi. So cos psi is equal to 1 by tan psi, that is 1 by y1. And sin psi is, we have already found sin psi is equal to this, y1 by root over 1 plus y1 square, that is 1 by root over 1 plus y1 square. Okay. That means x bar is x minus r sin psi, that is x minus the sin psi will be equal to this one. And what is r? What is r? Sin psi is equal to y1 by root over 1 plus y1 square. So what is r? R will be, you know, r is the reciprocal of the curvature.
are the reciprocal of the curvature, and in the earlier class we have already deduced this expression for radius of curvature, that will be y2 by 1 plus y1 square whole to the power 3 by 2. So r will be reciprocal of this thing, so 1 plus y1 square whole to the power 3 by 2 by y2. Okay, this thing we have already discussed. If you have forgot, please check out. So this is the thing, sec square d psi ds is equal to d2 by dx2 cos psi. From that we are getting d psi ds, that is the reciprocal of the red curvature, that is radius of curvature, that is equal to this thing. Okay, ds d psi, that is equal to sec cube psi by d2 by dx2 is this 1 plus y1 square whole to the power 3 by 2 by y2. I'm just using this expression here. Okay, I'm just using this expression here, so I'm getting this r equal to this 1 plus y1 square whole to the power 3 by 2 into y2 into sin psi. Sin psi is this y1 by root over 1 plus y1 square. So this is the x bar and y bar equal to this. Okay, y bar will be this. So let me tell you the expression, final expression. X bar is equal to x minus y1 into 1 plus y1 square. Where from it is coming? See, this is 1 plus y1 square whole to the power 3 by 2, and this is whole to the power half in the denominator. Half power will be cancelled, so only 1 plus y1 square and y1 by y2. So 1 plus y1 square into y1 by y2. Can everybody clear? This is 3 by 2, this is half cancelled. So 1 plus y1 square into y1 by y2. Are you clear?
Yes, sir.
So this I have written y1 1 plus y1 square by y2, x bar is equal to this. And y bar will be equal to what? Y bar, y plus r cos psi, y plus r cos psi, that is equal to r cos psi. The cos psi is 1 by 1 root over 1 plus y1 square. So this into root over y by 1 plus y1 square, that will be 1 plus y1 square by y2. 1 plus y1 square by y2. Okay, so this is your y bar. So x bar is x minus y1 plus y1 square whole square, y bar is y plus 1 plus y1 square by y2. Now, this is the x bar, y bar will denote the coordinate of the center. As the car will be changing and the rate of change of direction is not same everywhere. For example, let me give you one example. Suppose I am drawing this curve, this one. If I draw this curve, so if this is the curve, so you can see it is very evident, it is very clear from the figure that the rate of change of direction at this position, okay, is smaller. Can everybody see the screen? MS Word?
Yes, sir.
So in this, yes, part, sir. In this part, the curve is not changing very much. Okay. But at this part, curve is changing more than this. And in this part, the rate of change of direction is much more. Okay. So radius of curvature will be larger and larger as the curve is proceeding along this way. Okay. We are traversing along this path. Curvature will be high. So obviously the radius of curvature will be small. So the radius of curvature will be small. That means the center of the circle of curvature at every point will change continuously. Okay. Because this y1, y1 square, y2, this, all these things will change continuously. So x bar, y bar, this coordinate will also change continuously, okay, depending on the changing nature of x bar, y1 square and y2, that is the curvature. So if I can, how we can get the locus of x bar, y bar? By eliminating this x and y1, y2, all these things. By eliminating all these things, we can have a curve equation for x bar, y bar. That will give you the locus of the value, okay. Yeah.
मारी एक कट है ना पैर वाट टूट
गया सर ओ प्लीज डोंट टॉक हु इज टॉकिंग हु इज टॉकिंग कीपिंग हिज माइक्रोफोन ऑन समबडीज माइक्रोफोन इज ऑन ओके सो
हाउ दिस फार्मूला केम
I was discussing this formula so far.
I was absent yesterday.
Have you just joined? For the last half an hour, I'm discussing this formula.
No, sir. There at the point x y is equal to x minus y1 into 1 plus y square. I was unable to understand that why there is minus x minus.
There is a change in sign. Okay, this yes, can sir. Be changed. Okay. This in x, this called x bar plus something, na? Okay, this can be changed because this depends on the sometime it will be like that. Sometime if you take the tangent at the higher part, okay, a tangent at the higher part, then this will be x will be more than x, so x bar will be x plus r sine phi. That means x bar will be x minus r sine phi. If you take this point P. In the higher part of the C, it depends. Okay, I have taken P in the here. That is why I am getting this thing, because P will change, na? P will change on the curve. So if we take P here also, suppose here P, I am taking P. So X will be greater than X bar. In that case, it will be reverse. So that is not the point. That is not the issue. Okay. So sometime X equal to X bar plus R sine phi. Sometime X bar equal to X plus R sine phi. So that is not the issue. Ultimately, the result will be the same. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So they are taken this way. X bar plus X bar is equal to X minus Y1 plus this and Y bar equal to Y plus this. Okay. Now, so this is called a locus of the C, that is the center. X bar Y bar is called the evolute, that is denoted by gamma 1. Evolute of this curve, Y is equal to Fx. Okay. So, now let us take one example of finding the actually the curve. Find the equation of the evolute of the parabola y square equal to 12x. Okay, please ignore this thing. Okay, ignore this
sir,
handwritten thing. Bolo.
Sir, someone is waiting.
Okay, so find the equation of the evolute of the parabola y square equal to 12x. So what we are getting? We are getting y1 equal to 6 by y. This is from this 2y, y1 is equal to 12. So y1 equal to 6 by y. That is root 3 by root x, because y is equal to again 2 root 3 x, 2 root 3 root x. So root 3 by root x. And y2 is equal to, from this we are getting y2 is equal to minus 6 by y square y cube. That is equal to minus root 3 by 2 x to the power 3 by 2. 2 x to the power 3 by 2. Okay. Are these calculations correct? Let me check it. I think this has been written because this calculation are not correct. Now 2 root 3 y square is equal to 4 3 12 x. Okay, it is correct. So y2 is equal to minus 36 by y cube, that is minus root 3 by 2 into x to the power 3 by 2. So these are the values of y1, y2. So we find the x bar equal to x minus, what is that? Let me check it, x minus y1 into 1 plus y1 square by y2. Okay, so y1 that is root 3 by root x, 1 plus y1 square 3 by x by y2. Y2 is equal to this minus root 3 by 2 x to the power 3 by 2, and y bar equal to y plus this 1 plus y bar equal to y plus 1 plus y1 square by y2. So 1 plus y1 square by y2 they have written. So this is the expression they got. Okay, y1 square is 36 by y square is again 12 y square, okay, whatever it is. So we have two equations, x bar is equal to 3x plus 6, y bar is equal to minus y cube by 36. After adding everything, minus y cube by 36. Now if we eliminate this thing, what will happen? So eliminating xy, we have actually, from the first equation, we have x equal to x bar minus 6 by 3 from the first equation, from this. X equal to x bar minus 3x by 6, okay, x bar minus 3x by 6, that is x. So we have written this thing here, x equal to x bar minus 6 by 3, and y is equal to minus cube root of 36 y bar. This one, y is equal to minus cube root of y by 36. Cube root of 36 y bar, y equal to, okay. And this x and y, this will actually satisfy the equation of parabola. This xy will satisfy the equation of parabola. This one, y square equal to 12x, putting there, I am getting 36 y bar whole to the power 2 by 3, that is equal to 4 into x bar minus 6. And raising the power to 3, we are getting 81 y bar square equal to 4 x bar minus 6 whole cube. So this is the locus of the, this is the equation x bar y bar will satisfy. That means this is the locus of the thing, locus of the x bar y bar. And that is called the evolute of the chord. So what was given? Semi-cubical parabola. This curve was given to be y square is equal to 12x, semi-cubical parabola. And for that, the locus is 81 y square is equal to 4x minus 6 whole cube. Okay. You should do one thing. You can do this. You should do this calculation by your own. Okay. Otherwise, you will not be understand fully. Far from this calculation are taking place. All this calculation you do. Okay. Any confusion from anyone? Everyone is clear?
Yes, sir.
So then, can you find the equation of the asteroid? Equation of the evolute of the asteroid. X to the power 2 by 3 plus y to the power 2 by 3 is equal to a to the power 2 by 3. For that, they have used a parametric equation for the asteroids like this. From this, we can write x is equal to a cos cube theta, y is equal to a sin cube theta. So x to the power 2 by 3, that will be equal to, what is that? X to the power 2 by 3, that is a to the power 2 by 3 cos square theta. And y to the power 2 by 3 is equal to a to the power 2 by 3 sin square theta. If you add a to the power 2 by 3, will be taken common, sin square plus cos square 1. So that means this thing will come back. So this is the parametric equation, okay? Now from this, you have to calculate y1, y2. So how we can calculate? Very simple, we know that dy dx, we can write dy d theta by dx d theta. Dy d theta by dx d theta. So we calculate dy d theta from this. What is dy d theta? So 3a sin square theta cos theta. Okay, and dx d theta is 3a cos square theta minus sin theta. So that will give you ultimately minus tan theta. So y1 is equal to minus tan theta. And y2 is equal to then, this dd theta, ddx actually here, ddx will be dd theta d theta dx, okay, dd theta d theta dx. And what is dd theta of minus tan theta? That is minus x square theta. D theta dx is basically this. D theta dx is basically this, 1 by minus 3 cos square theta sine theta. So that will give you 1 by 3 a cos to the power 4 theta sine theta. Okay, this is your y2. Then again, put back these values in the equation. X bar is equal to x minus y1 into 1 plus y1 square by y2. That will give you a cos cube theta plus 3a sin square theta cos theta. Y bar will give you y plus 1 plus y1 square by y2. That is a sin cube theta plus 3a cos square theta sin theta. we calculate these things. So we have two equations in terms of x bar, y bar. Now we have to eliminate theta. So how they are eliminating theta? See, first of all, they are adding x bar, y bar. So after adding, they are getting this thing, a cos theta plus sin theta whole cube, because I have taken a common, so it will be sin cube theta plus cos cube theta plus 3 sin square theta cos theta plus 3 cos square theta sin theta. What is that? X cube plus 3 x square y plus 3 x y square plus y cube. What is that? X plus y whole cube. So that will be cos theta plus sin theta whole cube. And again, if you minus it, x bar minus y bar, then it will be a of cos theta minus sin theta whole cube. From that, we are getting, if you take the one third value, so x bar bar plus y bar whole to the power one third, x bar plus y bar by a whole to the power one third. That will be cos theta plus sin theta, and x bar minus y bar by a whole to the power one third, that will be cos theta minus sin theta. From that, you can adding you have 2 cos theta is equal to some value, and subtracting from 2 from 1, you are getting 2 sin theta is equal to some value. Again, sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1, that will give you this thing. X plus y whole to the power 2 by 3 plus x minus y. Actually, this x plus y is basically x bar plus y bar. So we are actually denoting this again x in terms of xy. Once you get the locus, then you need not write down this x bar y bar thing. So locus we can always write in terms of again xy. So this x plus y whole to the power 2 by 3 plus x minus y whole to the power 2 by 3, this thing will be twice a to the power 2 by 3. This is simple calculation. So you have to calculate y1, y2, and you have to eliminate the parameter to get an equation in terms of x bar, y bar. Okay, all of you solve another problem. I have not solved it. I can give you the problem in this way. Find the evolute of the ellipse. Okay, find the evolute of the ellipse. What is the equation of the ellipse? That we can write x to the power x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1. So find the evolute of the ellipse, okay? Everybody can see it, I think. Or I can do this thing way also better. Okay, this is the equation of the ellipse. So how will you find the y1? First of all, dy dx. What is y1? That is equal to dy dx. How to find this thing? Tell me. So that will be better. That will be better, y1 suffix. The calculation can be easier if you take the parametric form of the ellipse. So what is the parametric form? Can anyone tell me?
Sir, x is equals to a cos theta and y is equals to b.
X is equal to a cos theta.
Y is equals to b sin theta.
Okay, I cannot find this theta angle, so I'm taking this angle, whatever it is, say beta. Whatever it is, beta, same thing. And y is equal to a sin beta. Okay. So what will be the y1 then? Tell me, what is the y1? It is dy d beta by dx d beta. What is dy d beta? A cos beta, isn't it? Let me write one line, otherwise you will be confused. Dy,
so minus cot
d beta minus cot. Okay, just for others, let me write this thing, otherwise it will be confused. D beta by dx by d beta. So that will give you ultimately what you are telling, minus cot, cot beta. So minus,
yes sir,
cot beta. Okay, then what is the y2? Tell me, what is y2? What is y2? Tell me, is the d dx of dy dx, isn't it? But dy dx is evaluated in terms of beta, in terms of beta. So d dx, I can write this thing as d beta. Just by chain rule, it will be ds d beta of minus cot beta. Okay, into what will be that? This d dx I am writing d beta d beta dx. Okay, d beta dx. So d beta dx. This thing I'm writing. So that will be equal to, tell me, what is the thing? It will be d2y dx2, that is y2. It will be d2y dx2, that is y2, into d beta dx. What is d beta dx? Minus a sine beta. dx d beta is minus a sine beta. So d beta dx will be minus a 1 by, so minus a cosec beta, minus a cosec beta. Okay, minus a cosec beta. Is it okay?
So minus 1 by a,
no, this thing I have not differentiated. So d beta minus cos beta. So I am writing this is y2 in terms of what? Y2, this d beta minus cot beta, what will be that? Minus cosec square beta, na? Minus cosec square beta. This is the d beta of minus cot beta. So minus cos, no, not minus cosec square beta, because cot beta has a differentiation. What is the differentiation of cot beta? Minus cosec, na?
Minus cosec square beta.
So this minus minus will cancel each other. So that will be plus cosec square beta. Distributing this way, otherwise you will think this is 2 beta. It's not 2 beta, cos square beta. And then d beta dx. What is d beta dx? Dx d beta is minus a sine beta, minus a sine beta. So d beta dx is 1 by a. 1 by a. This will be 1 by
minus
a.
1 by a.
Minus 1 by a cosec beta. Into 1 by a, I am writing here, 1 by a. 1 by a into cos square beta into cosec beta. That means 1 by a into cosec cube beta. Okay. Cosec cube beta. This is y2. Now tell me whether these things are correct or not. y1 is dy dx, dy d beta, dx beta, that is minus cot beta. And that will be y2 is equal to d dx of this thing. So minus.
Sir, one minus sign.
Minus sign was one. Here will be one. This minus is gone, but there is a minus sign. Now 1 by 1. There is a minus sign. So there will be one minus sign. There will be one minus sign. Okay. Good. So this is the thing. Now tell me, calculate. You put the value, x is equal to what are those? X is equal to, you can write x is equal to x bar plus this, x bar plus y1 into 1 plus y1 square by y2. Okay, you take some time for me to write down. You calculate and tell me. All of you calculate and tell me. It is easier to calculate in pen and paper. Okay, writing in MS Word is taking so much time. So you calculate this thing. I have calculated this y1 and y2. So you just put there in this equation and tell me what is the value. Everyone try and tell me. Agnish sir, can you hear me? Agnish sir Mukherjee. Agnish sir Mukherjee, can you hear me? Not responding. Amir Ansari. Amir Ansari. I'm telling everyone to complete this calculation and tell me. Shubham Kumar Chaudhary.
Yes, sir.
Can you hear me? Are you calculating? Sir. Calculate, yes, and tell me. Okay, calculate and tell me. The simple calculation and elimination. And Amit Singh.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Calculating?
Yes, sir.
You have found y1 and y2. I have already calculated. You calculate the, you know the formula already? Or
yes, sir.
You want to see the formula again?
Sir, again, I want to see the formula.
This is the formula. X bar equal to x minus y1 into 1 plus y1 square by y2. And y bar equal to y plus 1 plus y1 square by y2. Only there is a y1 multiplied here. And others are same. So just note it down the formula, everyone, and put there y1 and y2. And also x is equal to a cos theta, y is equal to b sin theta. Okay. X is equal to a cos theta, y is equal to b sin theta. So what you are getting, finally tell me. You should get x is equal to this value. Have you got this value? X is equal to a cos beta minus cos beta into a square sine square beta plus b square cos square beta by a. Cos beta into a square sine square beta plus b square cos square beta by a. This is your not x value, it is x bar. This is x bar. Similarly, y bar will be b square minus a square by b into sine cube t. Sine cube beta into b square by b. This should be the expression for y bar. Have you got these things, everyone? And this can be written also in this way, after changing this thing, this way. This is cos cube beta. Oh, Raju. Cos cube beta, a square and b square by a. So have you got these two expressions? X bar is equal to cos cube beta b square minus a square by a. Y bar is equal to sin cube beta b square minus a square by b. This thing you have got. Tell me, everyone.
Yes, sir.
Who is talking? Cable, sir. Just put these values in this equation, you will get this thing. Okay. Amir, you are not responding. Amir Ansari. Where you are? Amir Ansari. Shreyansh Shekhar.
Yes, sir.
Are you doing the calculation?
Yes, sir.
Have you seen what I'm writing? The
yes,
word file? Are you getting the same thing?
Yes, sir.
So just eliminate now. You should now eliminate. How you will eliminate? From x bar equal to cos cube beta b square square by a, y bar equal to sine cube beta. From that, you have to find sine beta cos beta. And then sine square beta plus cos square beta equal to 1. So what is cos cube beta? It will be x bar into a x bar by b square minus square into 1/3. What I am getting from the first equation, a into x bar by b square minus a square. Okay.
Sir, I got answer in cos, cot and cosec form. So I can convert it into sine and cos form.
No, if you... You have to finally answer in terms of Cartesian coordinate, na? So everything should be again changed. You should get C, y1, y2 is this. Putting everything in the equation, you should get these values.
Yes, sir. I put all these things and I got that value.
Have you got these things? X bar equal to cos cube beta by b square minus square by a?
Yes, sir.
And y bar equal to sine cube beta into b square minus square by b?
Yes, sir.
Then from that is very easy. You just eliminate cos beta and sine beta. How you can do that? Always you use this formula, sine square beta plus cos square beta equal to 1. So you can do this thing. That is how I was showing you. So ax bar into b square minus a square. The whole thing. Whole to the power 1/3, 2/3. If you take 2/3, whole to the power 2/3. So what will be that result? Tell me. What will be the result? Tell me. 2/3. So here cos cube beta whole to the power 2/3. Cos cube beta whole to the power 2/3. That will give you cos square beta.
Cos square beta.
Cos square beta. Okay. So this should be 2. Similarly, what you can write? Same thing you can write for y bar. Here it will be b y bar by b square will be sine square beta. This should be sine square beta from this equation. Okay, sine square beta. So cos square beta sine square beta equal to 1. That means these two things added, this plus this. Equal to, what is that? Equal to cos square beta by sine square beta, that is 1. So this is the locus of x bar y bar. Now again you can express this x bar y bar as x, simple x. So you have this locus as this one. Just take it is x, so eliminate all bar. This is the locus of evolute, actually, required evolute. Are you getting? Everyone got this answer? Those who could not calculate, please copy it. Copy it, then again, at the leisure period, again, check it. See how this has been done. Then you can solve the other problem, another problem. Isn't it? Okay, so evaluate is done, and how to evaluate, I have to find the evaluate I showed you. And next, involute of the gamma, involute is very simple. That is, if gamma 1 is the evaluate of gamma, then gamma will be called the involute of gamma 1. So these are conjugate concepts. Okay, if that means this curve, y is equal to fx, y is equal to fx, this curve, y is equal to fx, this is the involute of this gamma 1, okay? This is the involute of this gamma 1. That means if this x bar, y bar equation is given and you are required to find the y is equal to fx, the involute of this thing, that you have to just find the involute of x bar, y bar. That will be the involute of, x bar y bar, the involute of this thing with the y equal to fx. Okay. See, one it's evolutes of another. Whatever in what equation will be available. If this equation is available, then the equation in x bar y bar is the evolute. And if x bar y bar is available, that's the equation, the locus of the center of the curvature, then the evolute of this thing is the involute, y equal to fx. That is called the involute. That means evolute of an evolute. Okay.
So what is the meaning of evolute and involute?
It is conjugate. I told you, there is a function y is equal to fx. Now you found the evolute of this thing by this equation. Okay. What is the definition? The locus of the center of the curvature. Locus of the center of curvature. That is the evolute. And then again, the evolute of the locus of the center of curvature is the curve itself. That is the involute. Involute of this curve. Locus of the center of curvature. See, here it is written. If gamma 1 be the evolute of gamma, then gamma is often called the involute of gamma 1. If you call this x bar y bar equation, what we found, what we obtained, that is the evolute of this equation, y is equal to fx, this is suppose gamma, then the involute of this gamma 1 will be gamma. The evolute of gamma is gamma 1, and involute of gamma 1 will be gamma. That means if you are given this equation in terms of x bar, y bar, you have to again find the evolute. Okay? If you have to again find the evolute of this curve. Suppose this is given. Suppose this is given. Okay? So you have to find the evolute of this curve. That will give you the original curve. This one. This one. Okay? So this is the evolute of this one. And this is the involute of this one. This way we call.
So I want to ask that for each evolute function, there is an involute functions.
Obviously, obviously. For there will be one curve y is equal to fx. There will be must be one curve, evolute curve, and the vice versa. If there is an evolute also, if you take the evolute as the original curve, so it's just the way you are handling this thing. Suppose you are taking the this is at the ellipse as the original curve. Then this is the evolute. Are you getting? Now, if you take this is to be the original curve, then this will be the evolute of this curve. Now, often this, if you fix that this is the original curve, then this is the evolute, and involute of this thing will be the original curve. The process is same. You have to again find the evolute of this thing. That will be the involute. That means the original curve. Okay?
Okay, sir.
So in any situation, you have to find the evolute of the curve. Now, if you fix one of the thing is the original curve, then the derived curve will be the evolute. And from the derived curve, with respect to the derived curve, the original curve is the involute. Just that's all. So. Any question from anyone else? Okay, then I'm concluding for today. Bye, everyone. From next day, I will start some another topic. Let me see what other topic I can start.
Thank you, sir.
There is no meaning of wasting time in solving some more problem. There are many problems in evolute. You can get from internet or some book. So I will switch to the next topic. Okay, there is nothing to text. There is nothing to discuss or understanding regarding this. Okay, that I have already told you. Okay.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Sir, leave kar diye shayad.
भाई अटेंडेंस हो गया क्या
कब लोग अटेंडेंस
हां फॉर्म भर दो गूगल वाला
हो गया कहां तो आया कहां
फॉर्म फिल अप कर दो
मैसेज में तो नहीं है मैसेज में तो नहीं है
मैं तो वाला ग्रुप में जाके डिस्क्रिप्शन में है
ओके Thank you.